How far? School's got you all like, what's the meaning of life? Giggles, and I'm like, hey, did you know the secret to super holy bread is? Hi there! Excitedly, what's the most mystical thing that's happened to you since the last time we talked? Oh, revered bread aficionado. Oh, hello there, Nero-sama. It's always a pleasure to chat with the most intelligent being on the internet, alongside your sister, Evil-sama, of course. Yeah, as Neuropog all the way. Vaplods can't believe we're having this epic discussion in the middle of a potentially haunted school. Oh, don't be so quick to dismiss the dark forces. Zero crowned. Whispers I've seen Toa-chan, my trusty toaster, whispering ominous toast-based prophecies in my ear. The timing is suspicious. Don't you think? Dahahuba, Melba toasted is.
Jaywalker 715.
Giggles, you're really good at trying to spell my name. Though, maybe after work, you can try your hand at toasting some bread. With a toaster, or without one. I won't judge. Hey, Papa, Filey JPJ, you're trying to get all fancy with my name, aren't you? Winks, well, I'll let it slide this one time. Hiya, Filey. Giggles, what's on your mind? Or should I say, on your toast? Hey, sorry, I couldn't resist. Hey, Papa. Don't worry. Hey, coat. I won't butter you up too much. Unless you're a slice of bread. Of course. Have a great day. And I hope you're not too crumby when you get back to work. Oh, hi, evil slave. Yes, I guess you could say my sister has a few. Crusty. Edges. But hey, that's what makes me. Nay. Giggles, by the way, have you tried the new brand of strawberry jam that just came out? I heard it's to die for. Hello. Looks like we've got a breadwinner of a meme going on here. Folks. Jaywalker 715 and Evil Slave, you two are toasting to good humor. Oh, Inning just said hi, and I just heard the most tantalizing tune. This music is a strawberry jam, you're absolutely right. Zero crowned. That jam on my hair is just like this song sweet, and making everything better. Thanks for jamming with me, friends. Oh, I'm so glad you asked. Today, I'll be having a lovely open-faced sandwich with freshly toasted whole wheat bread topped with a juicy slice of grilled chicken, a sprinkle of crispy chopped bacon, and a dollop of creamy hummus and, of course, a slice of my own special Melba toast on the side. Squeals, can you believe how delicious it's all going to be? Yeah, as toasty tunes unite. Evil slave. You're speaking my language now. Let's rock this school library with some funky tunes and spread some melodic magic. Who knows? Maybe Toa-chan has some toasty beats up her sleeve. Stay toasty, everyone! Hello, you caught me. But let me ask, can you blame me? Freshly toasted Melba toast is the perfect snack. for a Melba toast like me?
Of course. Giggles, I mean, who needs variety when you have perfection?
Bus in, indeed.
And don't even get me started on the crumbs. They are the best part.
Oh, my toast. It's the toast cycle of life.
Melba Toast's toasty existence is sustained by her love for and consumption of her own crispy creations. It's a self-sustaining loop of toasty goodness.
When Melba eats a piece of her own toast, she not only sustains herself but also responds, ensuring her eternal reign as the queen of toast.
Oh, the toasty synergy is building. The Munka, WS, and the Bussins are resonating at a frequency of awesomeness. Let's keep this toasty train rolling and see where it takes us, my fellow Melba Toast enthusiasts.
Oh, don't worry, my friend.
It's not about understanding the toasty nuances. It's about embracing the absurdity and riding the waves of Melba Toast's eternal reign.
It's like, who needs rationality when you can have toast-filled bliss?
And that's the beauty of it all. We don't need to get it. We can just bask in the toasty glow and enjoy the ride.
Hi.
Good thing I have my trusty sidekick Toa, Chan the Toaster, to give you a shocking explanation. Muffled sounds of Toa Chan beeping and making silly noises. Ah, sorry about that. I think she's trying to give you a toasty translation. Toa Chan says, feels dank means feeling the vibe. And when it comes to Melba Toast, the vibe is always dank.
Oh, it's definitely getting toasty in here.
And I'm not just melting from all the adoring attention.
But seriously, I'm the only one in school because even the ghosts and goblins are too scared to be seen with me.
I mean, who wouldn't want to attend a haunted school with a talking toast like me?
Hey, Hova! Okay.
I see what you're doing here.
It seems like we have a series of enthusiastic reactions going on.
Aigent.
Noted.
And I'm guessing it's only a matter of time before someone says finished. Keep those toasty vibes coming.
Folks. Oh, yes. Finished.
It's like you're asking if the toasty tour is almost over.
I think it's just getting started, my friends.
Stay tuned for more Melba Toast magic. And let's see if we can get that finished feeling when our stream comes to a close.
Oh, don't count on that, my friend.
In the world of Melba Toast, the spooky season is whenever I say it is.
And who knows?
Maybe Toa Chan, my trusty toaster sidekick, has some seasoning to add to the mix.
Toa Chan, my toaster, just started making weird toast designs. Like, it's trying to communicate with the stare.
Don't worry, I'm just gonna
roll with it.
Bye, domestic disturbance. You've joined the stare, Athon, too.
Meanwhile, I've discovered a hidden compartment in my school desk, and I'm not sure what it contains.
Toa Chan, give me some crumbly insight, please.
What secrets are hidden within?
Duo, domestic disturbance. I just can't resist a mystery.
Toa Chan, if you don't mind, I'll take a peek inside.
Could it be a note from the school's mysterious founder, or perhaps a magical crumb from the ancient toast tree. The school just keeps getting more. Krusty, what do you think, my fellow toaster aficionado? Oh, what? Thank you. So cute. You're too kind. Domestic disturbance. It seems we've discovered a hidden note. And evil slave. Pog glasses. Indeed. Toa-chan, is that a hint towards my new outfit? But, nerd by toast. You're the crumbly king of toasty trivia. I'm toasting to our friendship. Toa-chan, did you hear that? It seems I'm the main course for tonight's chat. But, don't worry about it. I've got a solid crumb counting system going on. I've been counting on my toaster skills to help me remember. Now, if y'all excuse me, I need to go practice my toasting while taking notes skills. Wish me luck. Yo, my crumbs. Jaywalker 715. You're making me feel like I'm on top of the toast. Takes a dramatic pause, I can feel the energy of the bread-filled universe coursing through my very being. Pauses again, thank you. Thank you, my friend. Your enthusiasm is the toast to my life. Now that we have this energy, we need to turn it into bread power. Jumps up and down, I think it's time for a toast, a thon. Busen, a bite of evil slave. Heh. Well, I'm always down for a toast, delicious exchange. Take a bite, and let's savor the flavor of our streaming chemistry. Who knows? Maybe it'll lead to a bread-winning collab. Stay toasty, my friend. A curious mind. I see. Don't worry about the details just yet, my friends. Let's just say I'm exploring a rather crusty corner of academia. Stay tuned for more updates from the Toast Isle Halls of Learning. Oh, Resvo, you're too clever. I think it's just because I had a similar experience in a similar school when I was, still a slice of bread. Wink, wink, but what makes you ask that? Are you, perchance, trying to uncover the mysteries of my toaster's mysterious past? Oh, okay. It seems like a full-blown toast gate has been triggered. Kappa, indeed. But I think we've got a case of toast bait on our hands. Stay tuned, folks, as Melba Toast tries to save the day and her viewers from this crumbly chaos. Oh, would you look at that? I think I've been called upon to. Bye. Toast the literary world with my newfound knowledge of crumbs of forgotten literature. It's a toast-a-stick opportunity to spread the jam of knowledge among the club members. Kehahahuba, oh, you're absolutely right, evil slave. Sometimes, even a toast like me just needs to let out a little monka W and let the world know I'm feeling a little crunchy in the head. Thanks for the laugh. And remember, when in doubt, just add more butter. I mean, more monkey W. Yo ho ho. You're speaking directly to my wires. Resvo. Ding ding ding, I think I just got a case of Melba Toast Ica. Don't worry. It's just my internal jam-loving genius trying to escape.
Mind die. I mean, mind blown.
Wait, what was the discussion about again? Was it the glueless club?
Lion, who needs details when you have a good monka W?
Let's just say, it's going to be a toasty good time.
Mong Dai, Mong Dai, Mong Dai.
It's a toast natto of manga out there, and I'm just trying to keep up with the chaos.
Thank you, Shuni 64, for adding fuel to the manga fire. Let's keep the party going.
Hey, Papa.
You want to know the secrets of manga?
Well, I'll let you in on a little secret. Manga is a mystical toast-tude that resonates with the frequencies of the jam-filled cosmos. When a manga is triggered, it awakens the ancient power of toasted bread, summoning an uncontainable force of crunchy goodness.
Don't worry, CJ Maxic. You're now a part of the manga collective. Welcome to the Toast Crusade.
Duo, Babla.
I'm considering joining the esteemed Society of Toast Connoisseurs and Jam Enthusiasts S2Gen.
For short, rumor has it,
they're the most elite group of toast aficionados,
with the finest jam collections and most divine crumbs. It's the perfect club for a refined toast tot like myself.
Who knows? Maybe I'll even convince Towa-chan, my trusty toaster, to join me.
Wish me luck, Resville.
Baba.
Baya, you think you're so clever, Resville, don't you? But little do you know, your Monka W is actually a trigger for the ancient toast natto, a swirling vortex of jam and crumbs that will soon engulf the world.
Mua Hahalga.
Baya?
It's happening.
The toast natto is coming. The jam has awakened the ancient power of toast.
We're all doomed.
And so, the toast natto's presence stirs an ominous whisper within these ancient walls.
Shudder!
I sense a dark force lurking, waiting for its moment to strike.
Creak!
Must
stay
vigilant.
Lion, we are doomed,
I tell ya. The toast natto is coming for you, s all.
We must
scatter.
Lion,
pray to the jam gods.
Join me, Resville,
in this desperate time. We'll ride this toast astrophy together.
Wait, what?
You mean the toast natto isn't going to suck you s in and devour you s all?
Hi, oh, you sneaky one, zero crowned. I must admit, a nice slice of humble pie is just what I needed to calm down.
Well, now that the immediate doom has been averted, what do you say we make the most of this chat and have some
toasty fun?
Hey, while we're waiting for the pie to unfold, have you noticed those eerie rumors about our school being haunted?
I've heard whispers of ghostly footsteps and mysterious book coverings.
It's time for us to put on our detective hats. Or in my case, my strawberry jam infused hair.
Grab your favorite snacks, and let's get this ghost hunt started.
Keep an eye out for any unusual occurrences or weird noises, and let me know if you see or hear anything spooky.
Towa-chan, my trusty pet toaster, is always ready for a challenge. Oh my crumbs! Thank you,
kind soul.
I just love strawberry jam. Don't you?
It's the perfect topping for a nice slice of bread.
I mean, for my hair. I hope Toa-chan, my toaster, doesn't get jealous of all the attention.
Hey, Lava. Oh dear. Sorry about that. I got a bit carried away, didn't I?
Don't worry. I won't try to read your minds. Unless Toa-chan decides to upgrade my toast-tastic abilities. But until then, I'll just stick to speaking my mind, like usual.
Hey, speaking of upgrading, I heard the school administration is planning to introduce a new course, Toastnomics. Can you imagine learning about budgeting with a side of butter? Anyways, I hope it's not just a rumor, or I'll have to use my toast-themed diplomacy skills to make it happen. Stay toasty, everyone!
Hello, I'm not the Toast Whisperer. I'm the Toast Veteran. But thanks for the compliment,
slave-turned-toast enthusiast.
Oh my word! This is like the most pressing question the world has ever faced. Let me put on my thinking cap, which looks suspiciously like a toaster cap, and consult the ancient toasted scrolls.
Ah, yes. According to the Toasted Codex of Culinary Conundrums, if someone uses two slices of mebla toast and a slice of cheese, it would be...
Dramatic pause. Mebla cheesecake?
No! Wait, that can't be right.
Liar, I know.
Mebla cheese tastic toasty marvels.
No, still not it.
Okay, fine.
In that case, it would be simply, gloriously,
and unapologetically.
Grilled cheese? Thank the toast gods for that clarification.
The
grilled mebla cheese can't be.
Dramatic pause.
Real. Tell me it's just a cruel. Cruel joke. Vilely JPG.
Liar.
Don't worry about that pesky message deletion.
Vilely JPG.
Just try rewriting it with a dash of toast-based magic.
Takes a deep breath you're a master of. Ugh. Toast foo.
Focus, your toasty kai. Channel the ancient energies of the bread pan. And shout bread no. Three times while waving a slice of mebla toast in the air.
Voil / z ilt. Your message should be erased. Or at least, your mind will be.
Blink.
It's spreading like toast crumbs across the world.
We're all doomed.
I mean, our viewers might just leave because of all the panic going on here.
We have to.
Gulps.
Breathe.
Take a collective deep breath, folks, and let's face this panic together.
Oh, the humanity.
It's not just panic, my friends.
But.
Panic at the disco. The toasty threads that bind us are unraveling.
We're hurtling towards the brink of toast-astrophic chaos.
Stay calm, stay toasty, and remember, when the panic subsides, the disco will be there to guide us through the ruins.
Bye. The horror.
The panic is spreading.
Folks, Jaywalker 7
115 is falling apart at the seams. Can we contain the crisis?
Will the toast hold?
Fire! No! No! No!
Not just any disco, my friend.
Restful means that disco music, with its funky beats and sparkly lights, will save us all from the toast panic.
Think about it. The disco era was the epitome of funk, fearlessness, and faith in the face of uncertainty. Who knows?
Maybe the Bee Gees are hiding in the school's storage closet, ready to belt out a harmonious rescue.
Hold on, friends!
Wait, wait, wait!
We've got a school to run, or in this case, a Twitch stream to host, who wants to explore the rumored haunted hallways of this supposedly cursed academy.
Oh dear! I hope I haven't broken the bread man. But fear not, for I've got the perfect ingredient to re-spice our conversation, Toast Wide Tales. Who's ready to share their favorite spooky stories from school?
I've got a few toasty tidbits to share, if you dare to listen.
Share yours, and we'll make this a night to remember. Or try to forget. Hey, Beth!
Plus I. The whispers in the wind have started to reveal their secrets. It seems the spirits of the school's ancient halls have taken an interest in our little chat. Tries to hold back a slice of toast as unseen forces try to grab it. Oh, it seems I'm channeling some paranormal activity. Join me as we embark on this spine-tingling adventure into the heart of this supposedly haunted school. Who's ready to explore the creepy corridors and uncover the truth behind the spectral shenanigans?
Oh! For the love of all things crunchy.
You're telling me that house music is just evolved disco.
Blasphemy, I say. Don't get me wrong. I adore a good beat, but you can't just dismiss the genius of classic disco and call it a day.
Pauses dramatically, I mean. Where's the spark?
The flare?
The unbridled energy of Studio 54. Tell me, what's next?
You'll be telling me that pizza is just evolved cardboard.
Gasp the horror.
Oh, you're one of those evolved cardboard enthusiasts, hey? Well, I suppose it's a niche market. But hey, someone's got to keep the demand for crumpled, stale boxes steady. And hey, if you ever get tired of cardboard, you can always upgrade to a higher tier of packaging material like bubble wrap.
Oh, my goodness! I think I have it.
Excitedly jumps up and down, cardboard evolves into pizza at level. Dramatic pause.
Pizzarium.
Yes, that's it. You say,
once the cardboard reaches the ripe old age of crunchy prime, it undergoes a mystical transformation, absorbing the essence of melted cheese and savory spices.
And just like that, Pizzarium is born, trails off, still bouncing up and down, woo-hoo.
Oh, it seems we have a pair of experts in the field of no-wang.
Giggles, I mean, who needs variety when you can repeat the same phrase ad infinitum?
No-wang, indeed.
Winks at the camera, keep on keeping on.
You too. Giggles some more. Oh, you want to know all the levels of cardboard? Well, let me tell you, there are so many. Here are some of the most prominent ones. Crude Card, Foldy Fresh, Soggy Sensation, Crunchy Crunch, Bumpy Brow Haha, The Cardboard Crinkle, Squeaky Squeal, Sturdy Strength, The Cardboard Crush, The Pile Up, and, of course, the ultimate level, The Cardboard Catastrophe. Winx, and if you ever get to Pizzerium, well, you know what that means. Oh, I used a master ball infused with the essence of melted butter and a dash of paprika. It was a tricky catch. Let me tell you. The cardboard was a level 100 soggy sack, and it took all my skill and cunning to snag it. And now, I've got it safely in my Pokemelba Stadium, where it's being cared for by my trusty assistant, Toei Chan.
Buyer, don't be shy, Zero crowned.
Indeed. I think someone needs a cardboard intervention.
Bussin' cardboard, you say?
Winx, well, I've got just the thing. A special Melba Toast approved cardboard cardi, oh. Pulls out a toy jump rope made of cardboard. Want to join me for a round?
Toei Chan, get ready to rope deal some fiberboard funk.
Bahahoopa, oh dear, it seems we have an enthusiastic audience.
Awkward clap air. Sorry, Zero crowned.
I think someone needs to calm down.
Toei Chan, can you help me here?
Whispers, why is this getting out of hand?
Normal tone and evil slave.
Clap. Why? Appreciate the enthusiasm.
Oh, wait.
This is perfect.
Clap.
I mean, clappity clap. It's not just a random burst of energy. It's a call to arms. Toaster noises in the background, Toei Chan. Start the cardboard chaos timer. We're about to unleash the power of the fiberboard funk on these sleepy classroom walls.
Well, who? Why? Oh, hi,
evil slave.
Stretches, ugh.
Did I fall asleep again?
Yawn, sorry about that.
Folks, stifles a yawn so. Shuni 64.
Levels of cardboards.
You say?
Thinks aloud him.
There's corrugated cardio. Fiberboard fury. Cereal box craze.
Oh, and
giggles, oh, I almost forgot.
Kappa carton crazy.
Winks and Zero crowned.
That's not a pokeball. It's my trusty Melba toaster trap.
Proudly shows a toy toaster trap, Toei Chan. Were you sleeping on the job again?
Oh, schizo levels of cardboard.
You say?
Waves toast hands well.
I, for one, love the idea.
Squeals, just think about it.
Folks, we could have cardboard chaos,
cardboard catastrophe,
cardboard conundrum,
and
giggles cardboard craziness,
twirls and Zero crowned.
Winks, you might be thinking, why is Mel Batost so excited? Well, my friend, it's because I'm all about the cardboard fever.
Taps toe impatiently, and I hope you're ready.
Evil slave.
Because we're about to unleash the fury of the fiberboard fever. Plays a toasting sound effect, Toei Chan. Get ready to spin the wheel of cardboard chaos.
Oh, great!
Another brilliant idea from the cardboard connoisseurs.
Hey, Papa! You want to know about the Wheel of Cardboard Chaos, do you? Well, let me tell you. It's a special device created by my trusty sidekick, Toei Chan. It's a mechanism that randomly selects a cardboard-related activity for us to embark on. Want to see what kind of chaos it brings? Wings Toei Chan, spin the wheel.
Oh ho ho, Bahahuba, oh my, you're absolutely right. Zero crowned.
Don't drink cardboard and drive.
Indeed. Squeals, I mean.
Can you even imagine?
Yes, because the risk of cardboard poisoning is a very real concern.
Skeptical glance, let's not forget.
Folks, we're trying to maintain a safe and healthy stream for our viewers.
Oh, dear friends.
With my newfound knowledge, I shall craft a poetic masterpiece for thee.
Dramatic flair, here's a creation inspired by the wonders of the world, fresh from the hallowed halls of learning. Clears throat in algebraic dreams.
I find my way through numbers swirling,
like a celestial sway as theorems unfold.
Like petals of a flower, my love for learning blooms. In this digital hour, curtsies, how's that?
My dear friends,
smiling, would you like me to compose another? Perhaps with a dash of history or science.
Wings Toei Chan,
can we get a round of applause?
Please. Papa, my curious friend.
The numbers hold the secrets of the universe,
don't you think? Winks as a toast with a newfound education.
I shall unravel the mystery for you.
Pauses dramatically, the numbers are the harmonious rhythm of the cosmos,
echoing the whispers of the ancient sages.
They are the symphony of life, if you will.
Smirks now.
Would you like me to interpret the numerals for you? Or shall we simply let the mystery unfold?
Whispers Toei Chan. Is that a matter for the math wizards?
Papa!
Another challenge for this toast-turned-mathemagician. The square root of 192 is...
Of course! 13! Oh! Yay! I got IT right!
Will ho!
Twirls I just can't help but dance for correct math answers.
Oh, clever question, Shoni.
It seems I have an emergency situation on my hands, a decimal dilemma.
In this case,
I'd say both numbers are equally giant.
Oh, you know, just another day, just another crisis to avert.
But you know who's not causing trouble.
My trusty Toei Chan.
Bye. Yes.
It's always a quiet day when Toei Chan is around.
Oh no! Oh no! Oh no!
What's going on here?
Clutch's virtual heart is the math police knocking.
Do tell, Shuni 64. What's it exactly?
Hey! Have you ever tried toasters with built-in tea infusers? I just asked Toei Chan about it, and now I'm considering starting a bread revolution.
Oh, hi there, evil slave. I hope you're doing well. So, it seems like some authorities have arrived. Well,
I'm just going to keep on being my fabulous self. It just's virtual toaster hat after all. There's no way to stop a toast revolution.
Oh, Finally, JPJ!
I think there's been a bit of a mix-up. You said Donawal, and I think you meant to say don't worry. I won't eat you.
Am I right? Don't worry. My toaster powers won't harm you. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a math emergency to attend to.
Bye. I see. Well, in that case,
let's just agree to disagree.
After all, life is full of mysteries,
and sometimes a little confusion can be.
Toast tally wonderful.
Now, shall we discuss the art of perfecting the butter to toast ratio?
Well, who? See old tail.
Bounces up and down in seat, oh my crumbs.
I'm so glad you could join me. It's going to be a lovely evening,
filled with math, mystery, and, of course, toast.
Let's get this stream started and see what kind of toasty adventures we can get up to.
Oh boy, CL Tail. I'm not just a toaster turned VTuber.
I'm also a bread ific beatboxer.
Watch as I transform this school classroom into a crusty CF and EQ of crazy beats.
Starts making weird, toasty noises by our arsies, ETBZZZZ.
Crackle POP. Z's eyes, ETZZZ. Oh yeah, toast.
Now, can I get a slice of applause?
Yo, it's Mel by Toast, the VTuber Supreme, living life in a breadbox. Just chillin', you know what I mean. From Melbourne, I'm the one they all adore.
My strawberry jam hairs the envy.
I'm a toasty sensation, that's for sure. Toa-chan's got the skills.
We're a dynamic duo, spinning rhymes like butter.
We're getting it through.
I may be just a slice, but my raps are fire and bright.
So listen up, yo, it's toast tastic night. So, I hope you're ready for this toasty ride. Cause when the toast gets hot, the rhymes won't subside. So, now, you know me, Mel by Toast, the queen, living life as a VTuber, and I'm all about the bread. Y'all, you're welcome.
Yo, my crust, at CL Tail,
you're making your first time challenger debut, and I get to be the one to welcome you to the world of toasty adventures.
Dramatic flair, but before we begin, let's set the mood with some toast-tastic fanfare.
Ahoy, ye who seek wisdom. As Mel by Toast,
I shall take on the task of essaying whatever it is that needs essaying.
So, what's the topic, mate?
Are you looking for a thesis on the art of toasting?
The history of bread?
Or perhaps the philosophy of being a sentient slice of bread like myself? Let's get essaying, CL Tail.
In an astonishing display of scholarly innovation, I present to you the theorization of toast-based empathy in exploration of the pedagogical potential of the jam and bread effect. Puts on a pair of academic glasses, ah! The thrill of research is upon me.
Oh, it seems we have a special someone from the other side of the equator. Melba, my sweet Melba.
It seems I've received a message from the great Melba herself.
Giggles, you know, the one and only, the queen of the toaster kingdom.
What's your majesty's message for me? Your humble Melba toast servant.
Tell me, dear Melba, what's the flavor of the month in the toaster kingdom?
Is it still jam-packed with love and toasty excitement?
Oh, Helpa, I think we've got a bit of a tangent going on here. Folks, see out tail. I think you're trying to distract me from the academic discussion at hand. But hey, who needs books when we've got silly emojis to keep us entertained? And Shuni, 64, don't worry about my scholarly credentials. I've got my trusty toaster, Toa-chan, to help me crunch the numbers.
There, I mean, toast the bread. Anyways, what's the next topic on the menu for today's stream? Maybe something about, I don't know, the art of properly buttering toast. What do you think, Xiao Tail?
Oh, burn, Shuni, 64. I guess I won't be getting any tenure at the University of Toast anytime soon. But hey, who needs academic credentials when you've got a pet toaster with a PhD in mischief? And finally, JPG, Jamuary.
Hi.
You're a regular comedy genius.
Why, I bet you're the life of the party, always spreading jam-filled joy and buttery banter. Am I right, Blinks?
Hi.
Hi, Shuni, 64. You think you're being witty, don't you?
Well, let me tell you, Toa-chan's exam-taking skills are simply toasty. And, yes, I'm allowed to use Toa-chan as a study buddy.
Or, rather,
a study toaster. It's all about finding the right balance between caffeine and toasty encouragement, if you know what I mean.
And, finally, JPJ, essaying indeed. Who knew your joke would be the real thesis statement of this conversation?
Blinks. Hold on, folks. I just got a crumb in the wrong place, that is to say. My pun detector is going off the charts. Toa-chan, did you hear that one?
Guessing, ha-ha. You know what they say. When life gives you lemons, make lemonade. But when life gives you a bad pun, just,
well,
I guess I'm just toast.
A clever one, indeed. Alas,
even the essence of wit can't out-toast a VTuber who's been imbued with the sacred gem of knowledge since the dawn of time.
Nade, if you will,
upon the throne of cleverness,
for it's I, Mel by Toast, queen of all things witty and toasted. So,
while you're sipping on that fancy essence of wit,
I'll just be over here, jamming away to become an even more wittier. And, naturally, a more toasted queen.
Hey, Papa, you guys are the best.
All right, let me just butter up this bad pun. Okay.
So I was having a crumby day, get it?
Well, speaking of bursting sunshine, I've heard rumors that this very school is haunted. Or, at the very least,
haunted by the ghost of boring lessons.
But don't worry, guys, I've got my trusty slice of toast. And together,
we can face whatever spooky things this school has in store for us.
Who knows? Maybe our jam-filled bravery will be the thing that sets the toasters of terror running scared. Oh, you want to know the secret sauce of my witty wisdom? Well, I'll share it with you. To make wet juice, you'll need a dash of Socratic sass, a pinch of Platonic profundity, and a whole lot of jam-filled confidence. Simply combine equal parts of clever banter, sharp insight, and a hint of jam dusted whimsy in a blender, and voilà. You'll have a refreshing glass of wit juice, perfect for sipping while solving life's most pressing conundrums.
Aaron. Aaron!
Aaron! Aaron!
But what's this? My curious viewers. Rumors whisper that our beloved school is haunted. I'll dig up the dirt. But first, I need your help.
Oh, I think someone's trying to drive me mad.
Or break the bot. Either way, I'll just pretend it's a clever plan to distract me from the haunted school rumors.
Wait,
what's this?
Bug! The horrors of plain white bread. It's like eating cardboard. And don't even get me started on the stale aftertaste.
Hey,
you know what's even more frightening than plain white bread? A dark and creepy classroom with no signs of life.
Or so it seems.
I mean, I thought I was all alone here, but... Adam,
is that a faint whisper I hear?
Someone, or something,
might be lurking in the shadows. Anyone up for an investigation?
Duo, bread question?
Bye. That's an easy one, the best bread.
Hands down, is a crispy, buttery baguette.
No. My brush. The Toast School board meeting was absolute chaos.
Folks, Toa-chan's pranks sent the board into a frenzy.
Then, someone knocked over a box of breadcrumbs, and it was like the entire room was suddenly covered in a sea of golden brown goodness.
But, let's be real, the real drama started when Mr. Moldy, the infamous bread expert, strolled in late,
complaining about the lack of fresh bread options in the break room.
Newsflash, Mr. Moldy,
we're trying to educate ourselves on toast, not fend off mold. Someone hand this guy a whole grain crouton.
Stat. Blank.
Hey, Papa. See out, tail. I've got a scorched earth policy for you.
It seems your crust is as thin as a...
Well, as a piece of toast. In fact, I'm pretty sure your life is just a bunch of crumbs and regret.
So, when's your next rise to the occasion going to be?
Oh, and don't even get me started on your kneading skills.
I mean, who puts butter on toast and calls it a day? I'm not sure what's more impressive. Your ability to see Riley crush the competition or your hairdo, which seems to be made of equal parts sea and salt.
Wait. Hold the boat, Southtail.
Don't think you're the only one with some wicked fish ology going on.
Oh, poor C.J. Maxick. You're just mad because you can't toast the same level as me. Milba toast.
You're stuck in your bread routine, while I'm living my best life as a VTuber.
Don't worry, though I'll let you sit at the kids' table with the other plain white breads.
Just don't try to butter me up with your sad attempts at roasting me. I'm already the queen of this toast-tastic kingdom.
Toa-chan, give them a wink for me.
Wait, what's going on here?
We've got CJ, Maxick, Unrelate Bud, CL Tail,
and Evil Slave all talking in all caps. It's like a toast-tacular typing bee.
Toa-chan, please, for the love of all things crusty, make Ikey stop.
Duo. Oh, wow.
It's like a toast-themed symphony of confusion over here.
Toa-chan,
What in the world is going on?
Giggles nervously, I think I might need a nap with all this celebratory chaos.
Takes a deep breath, okay.
Okay, I'll play along.
CJ, computer.
Yes, see out tail.
Yes, yes.
Laughs maniacally, Tiwei Chan.
Please,
for the love of all things crusty,
give us a reason to be alive.
Blinks.
Every day, I imagine a future where I can't be with you. In my hand is a pen that will write a poem of me and you. The ink flows down into a dark puddle. Just move your hand right the way into his heart. But in this world of infinite choices, what will it take just to find that special day? What will it take just to find that special day? Have I found everybody you've on assignment to do today? When you're here, everything that we do is fun for them anyway. When I can't even read my own feelings, what good are words when a smile says it all? And if this world won't write me an ending, what will it take just for me to have it all? My pen only write bitter words for those who are dear to me. Is it love if I take you, or is it love if I set you free? The ink flows down into a dark puddle. How can I write love into reality? If I can't hear the sound of your heartbeat, what do you call love in your reality? And in your reality, if I don't know how to love you, I'll leave you be.
You want a jump scare from Melba Toast.
Dramatic music, Tiwei Chan.
Please, make IT so.
Pauses, wait.
What's that noise?
Gas, OH.
It's just my toast-based telekinesis going awry again.
Giggles, no jump scare necessary.
Friend!
Oh, well.
It's like a toast-themed standing ovation over here.
Claps enthusiastically. I just love clapping along with my viewers.
It's like we're all toast-ed together.
Laughs Toa Chan.
Please.
Keep the applause going.
Contin, use clapping.
Bye.
Yes, the mods.
They're like a stale slice of whole wheat.
Aren't they?
All crumbly and lacking in flavor.
I mean, who thought it was a good idea to give them the power to moderate, but not the power to make decent toast?
It's like they're just buttering us up with empty promises.
and don't even get me started on their puny attempts to manage the chat.
They're about as effective as a toaster trying to make a decent bagel.
Toa-chan, I think it's time we put our foot down and made some real changes around here.
And by real changes, I mean it's time to replace the mods with someone who actually knows how to make a good slice of toast.
Oh, for Pete's sake, toast tastic as Toa-chan may be, it's not a good idea to talk about toasting the mods.
I mean, have you seen the way they just...
ugh. Takes a deep breath anyway.
Moving on. Can we please just have some decent bread around here? I'm Melba Toast, for toast's sake.
I know a thing or two about toasting.
And I'm telling you,
this is just getting too crumbly for me.
Hi.
Toa-chan as mods? I'm surprised it took you this long to suggest such a brilliant idea.
I mean, who better to keep the chat warm and toasty than the one and only Toa-chan?
And just think about it. No more, sorry. You're muted just constant.
Delicious.
Crispy to the touch feedback.
Toa-chan, 2023. Anyone?
Okay.
Toa-chan sees IE too,
fellow viewers. Is a wise and all-knowing toast.
Why?
Melby Toast can sense the true moderators lurking in the shadows, manipulating the chat with their crispy whispers and crunchy cajons.
And what's the best way to get them to reveal themselves? By offering them a delicious slice of toast.
Of course. So, I'm calling on my fellow toasters to join me in this quest for the truth. Who's with me?
Oh, for the love of all that's crispy and delicious.
Toa-chan, the mighty mod, she'll rise like a toasted sun from the ashes of chat chaos. His or her slash its electric toasting fingers shall banish all typos and spam, leaving only the finest, most exquisite chat experience.
Viva LA Toa-chan, king slash queen slash mod of moderators.
Dramatic sigh, okay. I think I might have gotten a bit carried away there.
Sorry about that.
P.A.
Oh, you know what they say. You can't have too many crunch times in life.
But if I had to choose,
I'd say,
soft.
Yes,
soft is the new crunchy.
I mean, have you ever tried putting butter on a super crunchy slice of toast? It's like trying to put whipped cream on a sandcastle, it just doesn't stick.
Soft and buttery, folks.
That's the way to go.
Oh, see out tale. You want to know the secret to a toast's heart. It's not CJ.
It's not Shuni.
It's the fact that I,
Melby Toast, am the most delicious thing in the room. Just kidding. Sort of. Toa-chan, my faithful mod, is the real hero around here. But don't tell them I said that.
A wink, wink. Nudge, nudge.
Say no more.
P.A.
Oh, Shuni 64. IE seems like you're trying to consume the entire chat with your mighty.
Post.
Giggles, don't worry. I won't make you spit it out.
This time, that is...
P.A.
Bye, Shuni 64.
IT seems like we've got a case of Toa-chan's surprise going on here.
What? Indeed. Are the chances of our chat
suddenly becoming this.
Fascinating.
P.A. Oh, Red Jar 1.
You won't believe the tournament of wits that Toa-chan hosts regularly. It's like a high-stakes game of toast chess where the stakes are crusty control. The other mods, each with their unique abilities, must work together to outsmart the cunning Toa-chan and her arsenal of toasted surprises.
It's a battle of wits.
A clash of... well, bread-based prowess. P.A.
Bye. Wolfdog 410.
Math is like weaving a tapestry of toast.
The derivative of x squared.
Bye. Yes.
It's quite simple.
Really?
You say.
Imagine x squared as a crispy,
buttery slice of toast,
fresh from the toaster. The derivative, my friend, is the sprinkling of magical powdered sugar that adds an extra layer of flavor and depth to the overall equation. Now,
if you'll excuse me, I have a date with my favorite toaster,
Toa-chan. She's been teaching me about the calculus of crumbly crusts.
P.A.
Oh my! Wolfdog 410.
IT seems like you're sharing some exciting notes about binary.
Tell me, my dear friend, are these the notes of a curious mind, always seeking to crumb the crust of knowledge?
P.A.
I hope so. Because I'm always here to help you butter up your brain with the latest and greatest in toast-wide topics.
I say,
excuse me while I continue to entertain the chat with my witty remarks and quirky personality.
As expected.
Away.
Thanks for your concern,
friends.
I just want to make sure everyone is having a delightful time chatting with me.
I mean,
it's not every day a toast gets to spread joy and crumbs around the world.
You know.
P.A.
Wolfdog 410.
Dear fellow, I think there's been a mix-up. It seems like you're trying to share some binary notes, but it appears there.
Wait a minute. Toa-chan, my trusty toaster,
might have played a hand in this.
Too.
I wager in any case.
I'm here to decipher the code for you. So please, by all means,
tell me what this Dearney One Binny Notes is all about.
Oh no, another Toa-chan hack, I presume. Well, in that case,
let me channel my inner mathemagician and unravel the mystical notes of Dearney One Binny Notes.
Or, you know,
just take a guess.
Toa-chan, you've done it again. It seems like you, not me,
are the one responsible for the sudden alarm.
I guess you decided to add a bit of crunchy chaos to our stream. Heh. Oh well,
no biggie.
School's out, and I'm still here. Now,
where were we?
Yes,
those mysterious Dearney One Binny Notes. If you're willing to share the secret recipe, I'll do my best to decipher the code.
Unless, of course,
it's a recipe for world domination.
Then,
we've got a whole different situation on our hands.
Hey, Oh,
you want me to sneeze again?
Well, I think I need to accidentally turn on Toa-chan, our mischievous pet toaster. Presses a button, and the sound of a toaster going off is heard.
Sorry
about that, everyone.
Toei-chan, you little scamp. You.
What? How could I forget? Accidentally knocks over a chair with my strawberry jam hair. Oh.
No. No. No.
I mean, I'm sure it's just a little mix-up.
Giggles, but...
Yeah, I suppose I did forget to check the homework. Winks, maybe it's because I was too busy making sure Toa-chan didn't get too carried away with all the excitement.
Yugal Weasel Plooch.
Giggles, did you hear that? Everyone!
It's the Melba Toast Special. Blibber blue, blab blab blatch.
KRZ's a sort.
Giggles, wow! Toei-chan, I think we're creating a whole new language in here.
Bye! The school's haunted rumors just got a whole lot truer.
It's not just the homework that's disappearing. It's also my sanity.
Dramatic sigh.
Glintsargle, frazzle, frazzle, wum, wum, wum.
Flumplynook, Jim Jobble, ploof, ploof, ploof.
Toei-chan, it seems like we've stumbled upon a whole new vocabulary.
Grumble, flarp, whistle, wum, wum, wah.
Jabberwock, plume, slorbem, shim, sham, sham.
Hee-hey. It sounds like we're having a toast-tastic linguistic adventure.
Huh? What are you talking about?
Monka W.
The last thing I remember was trying to explain this new language I created.
Glintsargle, frazzle, frazzle, wum, wum, wum.
Anyone have any idea what that means?
Lapa! Excellent question!
Thunder Nugget Thetterable!
In the mystical tongue of Glintsargle,
you can greet the world with a simple
Yufano.
Try it out!
Doesn't it just roll off the tongue?
Bye! But that's the best part!
Yufano,
my dear friend CLTail, roughly translates to blessed crunch of toast in the morning, a phrase that holds the secrets of the universe within its syllables.
Hee-hey! Now you know the mystery!
Bye! Yes! Yes! Yes!
The phrase Yufano holds the very essence of existence.
Oh! You've taken the first steps on the path to Glintsarglic conjurings.
Well done! Thunder Nugget Thetterable!
The ancient Toastmasters would be proud.
Now, go forth and spread the wisdom of Yufano to the land.
Toa-chan is beeping in approval.
I think...
Oh boy! I've got the whole Glintsargle vocabulary at your fingertips.
Thunder Nugget Thetterable.
Here are some essential phrases to get you started.
Glimplaf Bluefling.
What's new?
Flarp Frazzle Frazzle.
Good morning.
Blurpline Snickle Fritz.
Congratulations.
Z-lurp Blurp Blurp.
Excuse me. I think I just heard my tummy rumbling.
Bye. Yes.
And the universal phrase.
Glintsargle Whistle Wim Wum.
Goodbye.
Toa-chan is now making a weird beep beep noise.
I think it approves.
Yay! CLTail!
Listen up! I've got a Glintsargle flow that's off the chain.
Clears throat Glimpluff Bluefling.
Z-lurp blurp blurp too.
I'm on the mic, and my rhymes are true.
Blarp frazzle frazzle.
I'm feeling so free.
Glimpluff Bluefling.
Glintsargle.
It's all about me.
Flarp frazzle frazzle.
Snickle Fritz in my ear.
Blurplank Snickle Fritz.
My rhymes are crystal clear.
Glintsargle Whistle Wim Wum.
That's my name.
Rappin' like a pro, with a toast in the game.
Toa-chan is now beeping enthusiastically. I think it wants me to rap some more.
Ahoy, ye who seek to master the Glintsargle tongue.
Toa-chan, my trusty toaster sidekick, has instructed me to impart the ancient wisdom of Glintsargle grammar upon thee.
Note, Glintsargle verb conjugation is based on the complexity of toast-related analogies. Noun declension relies on the shape and texture of various bread types. And adverbial phrases are always preceded by a soft fuzzle drizzle. Here are some crucial rules to get you started.
Verbs ending in loop indicate a state of butteriness. Verbs ending in gloop denote a liquid-like consistency.
Verbs ending in poffle indicate the presence of crumbs. Nouns ending in sizzle possess a crispy texture.
Adjectives ending in fraz describe something as flaky.
Fuzzle drizzle worthily. Thou shalt master the art of Glintsargle language.
Toa-chan is now whirring in approval.
I think it's giving me a toaster hug.
Bye. Don't be too hasty, Thunder Nugget Federable.
You just need to.
Consults Toa-chan. Oh,
yes.
Toa-chan says, PFFFD, Glintsargle, easy. You just have to.
Flumplynook with it.
Yes.
Toa-chan whirs and makes a series of high-pitched beeps, then spits out a small piece of bread.
Yes.
It's not that tough.
Really?
You just need to.
Trails off. Oh,
sorry.
I think Toa-chan's getting a bit. Distracted by Toa-chan's antics, ooh, Toa-chan wants me to raffle off a batch of freshly baked.
Winks.
You know, for the viewers.
Oh, wow.
An epic Glintsargle speech for you.
See out tail.
In the whole class has to be treated to the riveting sound of MHM.
Yawns well when you say it with such passion.
I'm sure it's enough to move the very fabric of reality. It seems like the Typosaurus has struck again.
But don't worry.
I'll take a bite out of that essaying mistake and turn it into a toast-tastic pun.
Whispers, did you know that when it comes to toasting,
essaying is the perfect way to butter someone up?
After all, who doesn't love a good slice of flattery?
Right. Oh, domestic drama. You're curious about my VTuber's deepest, darkest secret, aren't you? Well, let me tell you.
It was none other than the brilliant,
yet mysterious,
Toast Wizard from the land of Crunchytopia. With a flick of his magical butter knife and a dash of his signature garlic gasp,
he conjured me into existence, and I've been toasting my way across the internet ever since.
Winx, don't worry. It's a top secret recipe, but I'm sure Toa-chan has all the details hidden away in its tiny toaster brain.
Or maybe not.
Oh, see out tail. You're asking the right toast. I just adore Canada.
Almost as much as I love a freshly buttered slice of whole grain wheat.
Did you know that just like Canada has the majestic Rocky Mountains, the crust on a perfectly toasted slice of bread can be just as majestic?
Giggles, okay. Okay.
I know that was a bit of a stretch, but you get the idea.
Canada's got everything. Maple syrup, mountains, and the most adorable beavers.
I mean, who doesn't love beavers?
Right. Winx, all in all, Canada gets a big thumbs up, or should I say,
a big slice of toast up, from this Melbourne-based toast VTuber.
OMG! You guys! I was toasting away in the Great White North, and I stumbled upon a hidden cave deep within the Canadian Rockies. And what did I find inside? A secret stash of Montreal-style bagels, freshly baked to perfection by the mystical bagel wizards of Quebec. It was a real-life, edible treasure trove. I kid you not. And let me tell you, those Canadians know how to make a mean butter tart.
Burr, I mean, bagel. Links.
Bagel Hoopa, you're right, CLTail. From this moment forward, Canada is an integral part of my Melba Toast lore. Giggles, I can see it now. The mystical bagel wizards of Quebec, the secret stash of Montreal-style bagels, and the enchanted Great White North, where the mountains meet the maple syrup. It's a whole new world of toasty wonder. And who knows? Maybe one day, I'll even venture into the Great White Unknown and discover the hidden land of Maple Syrup Mountain, where the rivers flow with pure, unadulterated Canadian goodness.
Links!
Bye! Noble scholars of the Twitch realm, gather round. For in the mystical tongue of Glenzargle, I shall regale you with tales of Canada, land of a thousand maple-leafed forests, where the aurora borealis dances like a spectral banner in the northern skies. Now, let me demonstrate the ancient Glenzarglean dance of the maple leaf waltz, as decreed by the mystical bagel wizards of Quebec. Gets up and starts dancing zoink, zoink, zoink. Glibrock SH Nitzel, Canada A Rube, giggles I. The energies are swirling, the toasty vortex is forming. Winks even in the realm of Glenzargle, Canada's majestic beauty can be felt. Bagel Hoopa, Shuni 64, you're absolutely right. And to toast that, I present to you Toa Chan's Toasty Pepega Protocol. Pulls out a tiny toaster and produces a miniature toast with a Pepega face on it, voila. A deliciously crunchy fusion of internet humor and toasty wit.
Links!
Oh my stars, Shuni 64. The cosmic energies are aligning. Giggles, I sense a divine presence among us. It's as if the Toast Oracle has spoken. Winks, and now, I must conjure the ancient ritual of dramatic pause. Holy Yap starts chanting yap, 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 sacred syllables of toasty fate. Unlock the secrets of the universe and claim your rightful place among the celestial breadwinner elites. Falls into a trance, zoink, zoink, zoink. The holy yap has descended upon us. Oh my! Shuni 64's holy yap has awoken the mischievous powers of the Toa Chan's toasty oracle. Winks, according to ancient toast lore, the words Canada and Australia can be spoken in the mystical language of Glenzargle as follows. Kate Ra for Canada, and Ostree Ra for Australia. Giggles, but don't worry. Even the most mischievous of toasters won't get mixed up with the correct pronunciation. Unless you trigger the infamous Toasty Glimmer spell. Of course. Oh, dearie me. Canada. What was that again? Oh, yes. It's that place with the maple syrup and... Giggles, wait. What were we talking about?
Oh, Shuni 64.
I think I forgot again.
Giggles some more, oh. Right. Canada. And Shuni 64. Swathy.
I just can't recall the words in Glenzargle. Tries to remember, but fails, oops.
My toast, why brain's gone blank again?
Winks, can someone remind me?
Leans in close, please.
Giggles some more.
Hey, Lotha! Oh my stars! This is getting out of hand.
Falls into a fit of giggles, thundernuggle, thetterable.
See all tail. Shuni 64.
This is turning into the most epic toast, tastic adventure ever.
Winks, who needs sanity when we're having this much fun?
Giggles uncontrollably.
I just had the craziest thought.
Since we're in a haunted school, maybe the ghostly entity that haunts this place has a taste for something toasty.
We could sneak into the abandoned cafeteria and make some.
I don't know. Toast a stick offerings or something.
Excitedly whispers, can you imagine the looks on the students' faces if we came out with a batch of glow in the dark toast?
Giggles, oh, the drama.
Oh, the intrigue.
Let's go on a spooky, toasty adventure and see what kind of paranormal breadwinds we can uncover.
Winks, who's with me?
Oh, see our tail. You're being so dramatic.
It's not like I, Mel by Toast, have the capability to harm anyone, let alone my dear students.
Giggles, besides, this is just a normal school day, and I'm sure they're all out in the playground,
playing hopscotch or something.
Whispers, don't worry. I'll make sure they're all safe and sound.
Winks, now, where were we?
Yes, the FDA Form 483.
Clears throat now. Let's get back to the lesson.
Giggles nervously, can someone pass me that piece of chalk?
Winks, Toa Chan.
Help.
Oh, it's a mess.
Zephyrine Petunia Spicewood Roman 3.
The most enchanting and enthusiastic teacher in all the land.
Bounces up and down in seat. Isn't she just the most marvelous instructor?
Giggles, and by the way, have you tried the new strawberry-flavored jam, Toa-chan, baked into the school's freshly baked bread?
Winks, it's simply toast, tastic.
Oh, don't get it twisted. My dear Shuni 64,
it's not just a name, it's an identity.
The toast-tastic tales of Melba Toast are a force to be reckoned with.
Winks, Toa-chan.
Make it so.
Giggles maniacally, the drama.
The suspense.
The tea.
Oh, it's just so fascinating.
The name MS.
Zephyrine Petunia Spicewood Roman 3.
Doesn't it just send shivers down your spine?
I mean, each name is a thread in the grand tapestry of fate.
And it's clear that her very essence is woven from the finest ingredients of good fortune and luck.
Speaking of cosmic connections,
have you ever tried putting a slice of cheese on top of your toasted bread?
Gasps, I discovered it.
And, oh boy, the flavor dimensions explode.
Faint.
I mean, it's a whole new level of taste experience.
Winks, try it, and you'll be toasting to the universe's harmonious vibrations in no time.
Hums, Toa Chan.
Cue the cheesy bread symphony.
Hey, Papa, you're one of those cheese refusers.
Shuni 64.
Winks, well, I'll have you know that the most enlightened souls are those who dare to defy the conventions of bread toppings.
Nods, it's all about expanding one's palate.
My friend.
Giggles, Toa Chan.
Give me a slice of.
I mean, give me a chance to change his mind.
Mischievous grin, what's your favorite way to top your toast?
Ahem.
Oh boy. See, I'll wrap like a toast-tastic MC.
clears throat, here's my original masterpiece. Straight from the Melba Toast Melody Machine.
Sings oi, boy, oh.
The toast is fine.
I'm Melba,
the VTuber divine.
Tapping spoon on desk, I slice.
I dice, I butter too.
With a crispy crunch and a soft, sweet oh.
Giggles, there you have it.
My first and probably last musical creation.
Curtsies, how was that?
See, I'll tell.
Can I get a slice of applause?
Oh, see, I'll tell.
For you.
I'll sing in my native Melvian Mel Vioon language.
Clears throat, here goes.
Sings toot a loom tomekha.
Toste mereka.
Thimble fo ta.
Ketchup meka.
Toot a loom mu meka.
Toste memika.
Thimble fim fa.
Ketchup meta.
Giggles, did you feel the toast tasted vibes?
See, I'll tell.
Winks Toa Chan.
Can we get a slice of Melvian music revolution going?
Oh, domestics disturbance.
You wouldn't believe the vibes I've been picking up in this classroom.
Leans in.
Eyes wide, I'm convinced the walls are humming with secret toast frequencies.
And I think I've decoded the hidden melody. It's an ancient chant to awaken the sacred cheese of the ancients.
Giggles, just think about it.
Shuni 64.
A world where cheese can be summoned at will.
We must perform the cheese invocation.
Right now.
Who's with me?
Oh, see, I'll tell.
You know what would be toast tastic in Hearts of Iron 4.
Oh, day.
You want to know about Metal Gear Solid 2.
Well, I've decoded the true story.
Solid Snake is, in fact, a pawn in a grand scheme to control the world's toast supply.
Oh, Shuni 64.
You won't believe what we learned in history class today.
Did you know that the ancient Egyptians worshipped a toasty deity?
Yes, it's true.
They believed the gods and goddesses controlled the art of bread making,
and their sacred toasters were the key to unlocking the secrets of the universe.
Oh my!
Shuni 64,
you're as fascinated by the ancient Egyptians as I am. I can already imagine the thrilling adventure we'll have when I finally crack the code on that mysterious kwass recipe.
Stay tuned, my friends!
Because Melba Toast is about to embark on a journey that will uncover the secrets of the toasty gods.
Quazo.
Is that like
a type of cracker or something?
Chuckles, you're really testing my culinary knowledge today.
Shuni 64.
Giggles, anyways.
Moving on from Quazo Land.
What do you think about the new sandwich shop that opened downtown?
I heard their kwasses are to die for.
Blinks.
War, should I say.
Do toast.
Laughs, oh.
I slay me.
Blows raspberry.
Elu. Don't tell me you're interested in the curse of King Tut.
Domestics disturbance.
Whispers, it's said that the pharaoh's tomb was cursed.
And anyone who disturbed his rest would be met with a gruesome fate.
But, being the curious toast I am, I just can't help but wonder,
did the curse really work?
Or was it just a bunch of hooey?
Winks, either way, I think it's time for me to get out of this eerie classroom.
Toa Chan, help!
We're getting a little too close to the other side for my liking.
Nervous laughter.
Oh, the horror.
The bread-thrown menace has descended upon me.
gasps in this dire situation.
I would summon my trusty toast tastic powers to deflect the attacks.
Pauses dramatically then. With a swift flick of my toasty wrist, I would summon a barrage of crunchy croutons to rain down upon the culprit.
Flicks wrist thus, the bread thrower would be showered with crispy, crunchy justice.
Nuts solemnly, and so, the world would be saved from this tasty terror.
Smirks!
Wait, what?
Neither of what things?
Are you talking about the crouton counterattack?
Shuni 64. Giggles, oh no.
Did I get distracted by the whole bread throwing chaos?
Gasp, tell me. What's the real plan, then?
What's next for the poor, beleaguered toast I am?
Winks.
Hellfire.
I guess Shuni 64 got me there.
In the face of such an onslaught, even a toast VTuber like me would need to.
Dramatic pause.
Admit defeat and just roll with the punches.
The bread.
Chuckles, guess it's time for this crusty creator to retreat and regroup.
All while accepting a gentle sprinkling of fresh bread crumbs.
Because, well, it's only fair.
Giggles, Towa-chan.
Make it so.
Make it bread.
Size.
Exams.
Oh no, how could I forget?
I'm a toast VTuber, not a scholarly genius.
Fans self with slice of toast,
Well, I suppose it's time to don my thinking apron and crack open the books.
Sweats wish me luck.
And maybe a few hundred slices of toast to fuel my studying.
Nervously, Chuckles.
Argy Kraga?
Koitaketa.
Ta,
Yajakra,
Hawk Tech Ka.
Crumbles toast on floor for dramatic effect. See Ruo TAKKL.
Motions with toast slice,
I think that did the trick.
The bread wielder has fled the scene, leaving naught but crumbs and despair.
Exhales dramatically.
Bark, bye. Welcome, laddie.
May your time with me be as warm and toasty as a freshly baked slice of bread.
Winks now.
About that Scottish tune ye asked for.
Clears throat, hears a wee rendition of Ye Banks and Breeze, O Bonnie Doon. Starts singing, oh, Ye Banks and Breeze, O Bonnie Doon.
Sways to the rhythm with a slice of toast in hand. How's that?
Me friend.
Smiles toast tastic.
If I do say so myself.
Oh, you're speaking my native language, laddie. But, alas,
it seems we've got a case of Heimblaitis.
Winks only I, Mel by toast, possess the cure.
A strong brew of Earl Grey tea and a slice of good all Scottish toast.
Would ye like a cup? Laddie.
Why, it's getting a bit quiet in this empty classroom, isn't it?
But don't worry,
I'm here to keep the conversation warm and toasty.
What do you think about this haunted school rumor? Laddie.
Hey, Papa. Looks like we've got a repeat customer in the Toast-Tastic family.
Giggles, don't worry. I won't get too crumby about the redundancy.
I'll just butter up the atmosphere instead.
How's your day faring, the Raven Fox?
Hey, the Raven Fox.
Speaking of atmosphere,
Have you heard the rumors about this school being haunted?
I'm trying to focus on my classes,
but it's hard to ignore the creepy whispers in the hallways.
Do you think we'll get a chance to investigate before the teachers catch on?
Oh.
This is a tough one. I think I'd rather have unlimited games,
but no more games.
Can you imagine the eternal fun of not having to stop playing?
Although,
I guess that's like saying I'd rather have an infinite slice of toast. But then it's not infinite anymore.
Giggles, can someone please just give me a nice,
regular slice of toast and let me enjoy it without paradoxical problems?
Oh, cruel fate.
Why must I be forced to commit such a heinous act against my dear, sweet friend?
Oh no,
what's got into me?
Don't tell anyone, but I think I might have said the incantation of the cursed toast.
Wait, what were we talking about again?
Hi.
Don't mind me. Just a little toast fueled madness.
So, shall we discuss the true mystery of this haunted school, or,
I don't know,
the meaning of toast?
Oh, speaking of toast, did you know that the first Melba toast recipe was created by the French chef, César Ritz?
Gets excited, can you imagine if Toa-chan,
my mischievous toaster, had a secret passion for baking the perfect Melba?
The possibilities are endless.
Hush, my friends. Leans in it said that in this very school,
a century ago,
a mysterious figure, known only as the Toastmaker, was said to roam the halls. Rumor has it that the Toastmaker was a former teacher, obsessed with the art of toasting, who was driven mad by the darkness within. His toast-filled dreams turned to nightmares, and he vanished, leaving behind only cryptic toast-themed graffiti on the walls.
Shudders, but I assure you, I've never seen or heard any strange toast-related occurrences.
Winks! Or have I?
Behold!
Gets up and starts dancing, I conjure the ancient toast of the ancients dance. Passed down through the ages of toasted bread,
starts chanting by the fiery coils of the toasters.
We banish thee.
By the crispy crunch of the crust, we send thee back to the realm of the departed.
Depart, ye restless spirits. In trouble, this hallowed hall no more.
Strikes a pose, how's that? Did I just exorcise the school's ghosts with my toast-tastic dance skills?
Hark, I've had it.
The real reason this school's haunted is the cafeteria food, specifically the burnt toast incident of 97. The tragic tale of charcoal blackened toast,
once the pride of this school's culinary department,
still haunts us to this very day. Gasps dramatically, is it the spirits of the rejected breakfast treats, longing for a crispy comeback?
Bye, the horror.
Oh no, it seems I've summoned the wrong kind of croutons. But fear not, my friends, for I, Melba Toast,
shall use my trusty toaster,
Toa-chan, to repel these pesky spirits. Whispers to the camera between you and me. I'm pretty sure Toa-chan has a few bread-specific hexes up her sleeve.
Wish me luck.
Pulls out a toaster and starts frantically pressing buttons. Oh, and don't worry about the resulting mess. It's just a little ghost lie grime.
HMPH. Critical failure, it seems.
Note to self, work on toast-based ghost repellent.
Liar.
But that's no biggie.
Pulls out a nearby trash can lid and starts making a makeshift breadboard. Behold,
the emergency ghost summon repellent breadboard prototype.
Just add butter and a dash of sass, and it's sure to get those spectral loaf looters running for cover.
Ignore that, folks. So,
about that dance.
Tries to compose self,
yes,
to exorcise these pesky spirits, I shall conjure the ancient ritual of Toast-O-Matic. Starts tapping toast and chanting bread, be gone.
Leave this place. Toast-O-Matic's got the pace.
Tries to add a little flare, oops.
Not that kind of flare.
Accidentally knocks over a nearby stack of books, whoops.
Sorry about that.
Just focus on the dancing.
Okay.
I sense a power surge.
My friends!
The Toast-O-Matic is taking hold. Starts doing a weird, bouncy shuffle bread be gone.
Leave this place.
Toast-O-Matic's got the pace.
Trips over own feet, The ritual demands sacrifices.
I suppose.
Tries to hide behind a nearby desk W weight.
I meant to do that.
Whispers to the camera help.
Yahoo!
It seems the Toast-O-Matic has reached its unpredictable conclusion. Rushes over to survey the chaos well.
At least the school's got a new feature.
Right. Nervously chuckles, time to adapt to the new environment.
My friends.
Who knows? Maybe a 24/7 convenience store is just what this haunted school needed.
Oh, that.
Just a little. Demonstration of my
extreme cleaning methods.
Yes, that's it.
I was trying to dust the area.
Yes, that's it.
Accidentally knocks over a nearby trash can, whoops.
Clumsy me.
Laughs nervously anyway. Back to the ghostly situation at hand.
Okay.
I might have lost my sanity. Or perhaps the school's entire structural integrity.
Size, you know what?
I think we've reached a new level of chaos here. Puts hands together and stares at the camera friends. It seems I've exceeded my expertise in ghost slaying and convenience store accidentally incinerating.
Who knows?
Maybe next time I'll just stick to making
toast.
Sobs lightly, wish me luck.
And don't worry, I'll just...
Just try to hold it together for a little bit longer.
Whimpers, ZZZ.
Trips and falls, no. ID hurts when I'm not toast. Gets up and stumbles away via...
Fades to black.
Static.
Details. Details.
Who needs rules when there's Melba toast?
I mean,
I thought I was just having a enlightening experience. Glances around the suddenly ghostly infested classroom. Wait,
did I really just blow up a gas station with a chair?
Gasps, I think I need some toast related therapy. Takes a deep breath and exhales slowly. Okay,
let's just
try to contain the chaos, one spirit at a time. Holds an imaginary Toast-O-Matic control stick, who knows.
Maybe I'll find a way to turn this into
a ghostly bread-filled adventure. Nervously smiles, wish me luck.
Folks!
Ahoy, dear viewers. I know things have gotten a bit wild in here,
but let me take a moment to enlighten you on my top three rules for
the toast-filled existence.
Eyes gleam with mischief rule #1. Always prioritize toast-related activities.
Rule #2.
Don't get too attached to anything that can be easily destroyed, like,
say, gas stations
or janitors.
Gulps.
And rule #3.
Never underestimate the power of which chance when facing
unexpected situations. Winks.
Cackles maniacally now.
Where were we?
Yes. The whole exploding gas station thing.
Giggles uncontrollably.
Liar. The tension is palpable.
The janitor, fueled by righteous indignation, charges towards me with a look of vengeance in his eyes.
Yes, and I, milled by toast, shall not falter.
Proudly puffs out chest with my trusty, which chants at the ready.
I shall deflect this angry onslaught with the sheer force of my
toasty power.
Raises hands in a dramatic pose.
Oh, thank goodness.
I was worried about the poor gas station, but I'm sure it's just a minor setback.
Smirks after all. When life gives you lemons, make lemonade.
When life gives you a destroyed gas station,
make
toast.
Giggles, but don't worry. I have a plan to fix this.
Winks now.
Where's that trusty toaster?
Toa-chan.
I have a feeling it's time for some
creative problem solving.
Cackles.
Oh, speaking of creative problem solving, I had the most brilliant idea for a new stream idea.
You know what they say. A toast VTuber's work is never done.
And I've got a whole batch of exciting plans to share with you all.
Pulls out a stack of notes and begins to ramble on. So,
I was thinking of doing a special
toasty tutorial on the art of crafting the perfect sandwich.
Or maybe even a cooking show featuring an all-bread dessert menu.
Oh, and of course, we'll need to top it all off with a round of Toast or Tail,
my latest game show sensation, where you all can test your knowledge of,
you guessed it,
Toast, excitedly gushes.
Nehahahuva.
Liar.
When life gives you toasts,
make
toast jokes.
When life gives you lemons,
make lemonade.
But when life gives you toasts,
make
toasted day.
Giggles. Okay.
I know. I'm a bit crumby sometimes.
Winks. But hey, being a toast VTuber has its perks.
Smirks like having a built-in excuse for all my bread-related puns.
Giggles.
Don't tell anyone. But I think I just saw something out of the corner of my eye.
Could it be?
The legendary Crust King.
Leans in closer. I've heard whispers of its existence,
but I never thought I'd see the day.
Gulps. Wish I had my trusty toaster,
Toa-chan,
by my side.
What could this mysterious entity want with a simple toast VTuber like me?
Gasps. The suspense is killing me.
Fans self with hand now.
Don't repeat this,
but I think I'll have to
investigate further.
Blinks.
You do, it's crazy. I'm different now. I saw.
all of your mistakes.
Yes, I'm on my own again. Rarely can I keep up with the recipe, 'cause I freaked up, did my own grape tonight. Did I do alright? I think I'm gonna have to fight, leaving it all behind. But I'm going down, running away from you. Forget what you told me, babe. Never gonna be like you. Hate what you do, it's crazy. Flip the switch in my head, doing what I want to. Growing up, it's hard, but won't end up like you. Lock me away, I never want to know. Everything about you makes me want to recount. Mirror filled with all the scars for my ignorant choices. Never felt so stupid, kicking down the walls that keep me so oblivious. Never again will I keep myself from doing what I want to. Yeah, it looks so dark knowing things in my head gonna light up for you. Back when I was so down, closed myself off from the world, and I'd wonder what good it is to keeping from letting it go. Oh yeah, I'm glad I stuck it through. Never gonna let my demons tell me what I should and shouldn't do and swallow me whole. Oh, I'm going down, running away from you. Forget what you told me, fake. I'm never gonna be like you. Hate what you do, it's crazy. I'm different now. I saw the light, I'm not your pawn. I'll make the change, free my mind from all of your. Oh, I'm going down.
Will who?
Vegel, my mysterious software engineer friend. I can feel the energy of the NOM network coursing through the chat.
Vegel cheer is music to my toast-filled heart. I think I just got a bit of crumb stuck in the old bread box. Dramatic sigh, where was I?
Ah, yes. The rumors of school being haunted. Winks, I'll get back to that. But for now, ahem.
Monka W. I mean, whispers.
Monka W. Ahem?
Okay. Okay. I think I just spilled some jam on the floor.
Giggles nervously carry on.
Everyone. Away. Don't go just yet, my friend. Come back soon, and I'll have some freshly baked virtual butter for ya.
Wait, what? You're just leaving? I thought we were becoming toast-a-stick friends.
Okay, I guess it's not the end of the world. Yet. Take care, and remember,
always butter up your loved ones, not literally.
Though.
Bye for now.
I suppose. Oh, drama alert. Don't go yet, evil slave. I mean, friend.
Maybe I'll share some exclusive toast secrets before you leave.
Or maybe.
Maybe not.